In this video, I'll teach you how to create mental effect in 3D in a procedural way. This video is inspired by Cody's video he uploaded a few weeks ago.
First of all, to create this effect, we need to understand normal maps. In 3D, normal is the direction the surface is facing, and it uses RGB color values to encode directional information about the surface normal at each pixel, which means normal decides how the light should behave when it hits the surface of 3D object to provide the illusion of three-dimensionality on a plane surface. So what we are going to do is trick the software to render this to this with the help of normal map. Let's start by creating a Voronoi texture. If you control shift and click the Voronoi texture, you can see a Voronoi texture is applied. If you connect the color to material output, you start to see mosaic, but we are not going to use it either. If you see the position, you will see texture like a normal, but the problem is the edges of this normal is too sharp. Now create a noise texture, texture coordinate, and a mix node, and change the data type to color in a mix node. From the noise texture, connect color to A in a mix node. In a blending option, change mix to subtract, duplicate the mix node, connect result to B and object to A. Connect result from mix node to vector input in a Voronoi texture. If you increase factor to 1 in the first mix node and decrease the factor second mix node, if you increase the scale of a noise texture, you should notice some blur effect going on. Select these 4 nodes and press Ctrl Z to group them together. Now connect factor from second mix node and scale from a noise texture to group input. Go to the group tab, rename inputs, blur amount and blur quality accordingly. Press tab to exit from this node group. You can now change the variables from this node group itself. Let's call this node group blur and duplicate Voronoi texture and blur 2 more times. Create a mix node with color data type and connect position from Voronoi texture 1 and 2 to A and B. Duplicate the mix node and connect result from mix node 1 to A and position from last Voronoi texture to B. Select these nodes, press Ctrl Z to group them together. Out of these 3 node groups, we will use first to create smaller details and second and third for a bigger one. Connect all 3 blur node groups and scale from Voronoi textures to group input as shown here. Rename group input so later you can easily recognize what node you are modifying or changing the variables. Now let's connect factor from both mix node to group input so later it makes easier to blend between small detail and big brush strokes. And rename these group inputs as well. Now again, press tab to exit from this node group. Select the node group and rename it whatever you want. I'll call it Painterly effect. Connect the result from node group to normal. Control shift and click on principal BSDF. You can see result in your viewport. Don't be afraid to change the value of a node group. It is very customizable node. Experiment with it to get the result you are looking for. Here's the scene I've created from the models downloaded from polyheaven.com. Now let's add some minor details to the models to achieve even more painterly effect. Since the table is low poly, let's add more details to it. To give it more organic shape, let's add displacement map with cloud texture applied. Change the scale of cloud texture according to your need. Also reduce the strength of displacement map to the point it's barely noticeable. Do same for all the other objects if you think it makes it better, else you don't have to do. I didn't use displacement map in the wall and fruit. I hope this was helpful. There's a download link in the description. If you have any questions or suggestion, please leave a comment.